Hey boys, hey girls, welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes. I've been getting a lot of questions about cast iron care. And you can go to Lodge's website and they've got step by step of how to re-season your pan, or pot, or cast iron cookware. And they are the leading manufacturer in the United States. First, let's talk about when you buy cast iron. If you buy pre-seasoned, it's ready to go. Just rinse it out with water, hot water. Don't scrub it. Don't do nothing to it. Rinse it out and dry it. You can put it on a burner on your cooktop and get it warmed up. Don't overheat it, but get it warmed up. You're ready to cook in. Want to make sure there's no water in it. And the surface of cast iron is very porous. Okay, it's here's a picture of it. And those pores, they've got little pinholes and deep pockets in it, and valleys and hills and things. And the coating, the thicker you get your polymerized coating of oil, burned on oil in other words, the seasoning, the more that gets filled in over time. But it can be damaged. It's really, really hard. It's it's polymetric layers of oil that have been vaporized and burned into the surface. And the most common oil to use is just a vegetable oil. Back in the old days, everybody used animal oils, lard, you know, bacon fat, whatever. So, Lodge recommends soybean oil. That's what they use to pre-season their stuff with. This is a newer pan. I guess you can see its surface somewhat. It's a rough sand cast surface in this pan. And you can see where I've got too much oil in it in spots. So it really needs to be re-seasoned totally. And what you can do, you can either put this on a gas cooktop, get it hot as hell, I mean like red hot, or put it in a self-cleaning oven for the cleaning cycle, and it'll burn this coating off, or in a campfire. Then you can start over again. Now the older cookware, like this one, actually has a very smooth surface on the bottom. And that surface, when it was manufactured, it was smoothed out probably on some type of milling machine and then hand sanded. Machine sanded. You can take a newer one. You're not going to find one of them, a new one that's been sanded. You'll have to get one and sand it. You'll have to get a drill motor, preferably electric, one that's got a helper handle on it so you can bear down on it. Clamp it in a vise. Clamp that sucker off in a vise, and you can get a round sanding pad. Disc and start out coarse and work. And cast iron is hard as a rock. It's going to take a couple of hours to get it down smooth, and you're going to have to keep going to a finer sandpaper to get it smooth as you want. And then you wash it off good. Wear a dust mask because you don't want to breathe all that. The iron fumes ain't bad for you, but it gets in your nose and it's yucko smelling. Now, if you get one that you left to get rusty or you overheated and it rusted like this, and it's time for a wire brush on a drill motor. If it's really bad, you can get a wire brush cup wheel, a cup type wheel, and put it in a battery drill or a drill and get the rust out of it, wear a dust mask. wash it good, just hot water. You don't need to put soap in it, because you'll have scrubbed everything out of it with just the cup wheel, and then season it. And the way you season it is you put a layer of oil in it, and wipe it out with paper towel. You're supposed to put it upside down in like a 350 degree oven. I like 400. I'll do mine on the stovetop. Just wipe it down good. Put it over a gas burner, over medium low, and let it sit there for an hour. I'll apply another coating and do it again. Every time you cook with it, regardless of how smooth it is, go ahead and clean it. Make sure it's dry. Don't let it sit with water in it. Because if there's a pinhole in the coating, it can cause the coating to start flaking off. It can get down in that pinhole and loosen the rest of it. And then you'll have to strip it again down a bare metal box, over a campfire or in a self-cleaning oven. Once you do that, you've got to pay real close attention because it can start to rust quick. I mean, as soon as it cools enough to handle, go ahead and rinse it out, put it on a burner, on the cooktop, to dry it thoroughly. And it may start rusting right then. So wipe it down with a paper towel, a dry paper towel, and then put some oil on it and start the seasoning process. Reapply the seasoning process. Excuse me one second. One easy way to clean them is you can get these stainless steel scrub pads, okay? And they're pretty rugged. And they're coarser than steel wool, and they're not really going to scratch this coating up, but they'll knock off anything loose that's stuck in the pan. After using the scrub pads, put them in the dishwasher across the tines. If you don't have one of them, you can just use you better go ahead and get one. I'll use that with some table salt in a dry pan, about a quarter cup of salt, table salt. And that acts as a sandpaper. And you can really get down on say if it's in bad shape. And in need of re-seasoning. And every time you use it, clean it, wipe it dry, heat it on a stove, put a little bit of fresh oil in it. Make sure you get all oil out and put another layer of coating on it. That layer is super thin. You want to build it up as much as you can. And you're not going to scratch it with steel. I mean, you can take a steel spatula and go around this, and you're not going to hurt that coating. Ain't going to hurt it at all. You can think of it almost as a glass coating or a porcelain enamel coating. You know, one of the best things to do with cast iron is to fry something in it. Deep fry or make fried chicken. Make a roux in it, man. It's great for making a roux.
You talk about adding some flavor to that coating.
And in Asia, what they do to season their woks, because a wok will come with either a shellac or a wax finish on them when they're brand new to keep them from rusting, because they're carbon steel. And if you buy unseasoned cast iron pan, it's going to have that kind of crap on it too. You need to scrub that off with hot soapy water. And you know, you get you some steel wool or a scouring pad like this and get all that crap off and then season it. But in Asia, what they'll do is they'll use vegetable oil and onions or scallions to season their woks with initially when they're brand new, and to reseason them because that adds a little flavor to it, just like cooking bacon in them, and or using bacon fat to reseason it with. That's why we like to use cast iron for Cajun dishes like jambalaya, where we frying sausage down and then cooking the Trinity in it, the onions, you know that adds a flavor to that layer that you make.
Build that coating up.
Just don't leave the food sit in it after you've cooked. Go ahead and remove it. Clean the pan right then. Don't let it sit overnight. Don't let it soak in water. And some people say, oh, what about cooking acids? Tomatoes, stuff with wine in it. Some people say, oh yeah, I do it all the time, it's no problem. If you got a thick enough coating, it's no problem. But if there's a pinhole in it, it can get in there and react with the bare cast iron underneath the coating and off flavor your food. So I wouldn't do it. I don't do it. If you do it, do it briefly. Don't leave it sit in there for very long. Like if you're going to cook something for 4 hours, don't use cast iron. That's got acid in it. I've actually got a cast iron, Dutch oven that's ceramic coated. Or not ceramic, what's the word for it? Yeah, it's porcelain enamel coated. And you can do anything you want with that because you're not going to hurt that coating. And it's not going to, well, I say that, you can chip it because it's a glass. You could chip that actually too because that polymerized polymetric coating is like as hard as a glass. It's a carbon compound that's, like if you hit it with a screwdriver with a hammer on the back, yeah, you can chip it off. And you don't want to eat that either, so don't do it. Cook in them, scrape in them. Watch. Metal spatula. It ain't gonna scratch shit. It just ain't gonna scratch it. It ain't gonna harm it at all. But don't beat on the inside the pan with that, because you can chip it. I hope y'all learned something. And this was by request, this video, so y'all enjoy it.
Here's one that I purposely burnt the seasoning out of it to start over, and I'm getting ready to start over. Now, you can grill steaks indoors, but it's going to smoke like a fool in your cast iron. So let them rest. Makes a nice crust on the outside of them when you do that, and delicious inside. And these kind of pans make pretty grill marks, but they're painted a butt to clean. See them marks on that from flipping it around? Can also get you one of them. Put it directly on the fire. Get it hot and brand your meats. There you go, JB Ribs Chicken.
Get your cast iron. Fry you some fish in it, or hush puppies, or shrimps, crawfish. What? Fry something.
Bacon. Oh, man. Yeah, you know, chicken. Everything. You adding flavor. Gratin. This is making me hungry. Be sure and rinse it and heat it up to set that new coating in. Heat it till it's not sticky anymore inside.
Till next time. Bye, boy, girl.